Episode 5 is called Life and Death, or Leben und Tod. In 1987, Tannhaus gets a visit from Charlotte in this episode. He shows her a photo of his son, the wife of his son, and their child. It turns out that they passed away in a car crash. He tells that two strange-looking women gave Charlotte to Tannhaus with the clock that says for Charlotte. Mm-hmm. So that's probably how she gets her name, I think, then. Got her name. The clock that the older Tannhaus also had earlier in the season. Also in 1987, Charlotte tries to get the keycard from Helena to free Ulrich. And this was really, I think in this episode, there was actually quite some brutal scenes.
Yeah. Horrible.
This was one of them.
So the backpack.
Helena, Helena gets into a fight with Katarina. They get into this fight, and then she hits Helena with a rock. So her mother, she hits with a rock. She hits her unconscious, so it seems. But then Helena wakes up, fights back, and she kills Katarina with the same rock. That was quite
kills her own daughter. Yeah, it's nice. Yeah.
Brutal stuff.
Yeah.
We then see Mikael and Ines arriving home just a day late for Katarina to meet them. That was a bit of a sad thing. Like, okay, just one day, and she
exactly. Yeah.
Met her son. In the parallel world, present day parallel, Claudia meets a different version of herself. The other Claudia tells her that there are two groups fighting for the time travels, Eva and Jonas. Claudia says that Jonas is part of the Shadows. She asks her to join Eva. Eva wants to save both worlds, Claudia says. She tells that they have to do everything they can to preserve the knot. Both have to do in their worlds what is necessary. Everything they need is in the book, she says. Then, younger parallel Martha, as I call the one that's a bit in the unknown yet, younger parallel Martha and Jonas try to get to the plant to stop the barrels from being opened when Martha gets a scratch by the fans. Just like
Jonas
the older...
scared.
Yeah. So, just like the older parallel Martha that Jonas met, then Jonas realizes that Eva might have lied, that everything will happen as it always does. That it's actually Jonas and Martha who trigger all this, and Jonas says they should no longer listen to her. Later on, he tells younger parallel Martha that he's in the wrong place, that he's wrong everywhere, that he couldn't and shouldn't have been. They left the plant and go back into the caves to arrive in the future at Eva's lair. Eva enters and tells Jonas that someone lives three lives. Mm-hmm. First, you lose your naivety, then you lose your innocence, and then you lose life itself. I found it quite a nice line.
That was nice put. Yeah, that was nice put.
Yeah. So Jonas's life ends here and now, she tells. He did what he had to do. Desert Martha.
Desert Storm, yeah.
Desert Martha and older parallel Martha enter. Older parallel Martha shoots Jonas and he dies. In original world 2020, Elizabeth is in the caravan when a man enters. The man smacks her unconscious. This is the second super brutal scene in this episode.
Horrible. Yeah.
So
a weird guy, yeah.
The man smacks her unconscious and threatens to rape her when she wakes up. This was also a horrible scene when they are sitting next to each other and you can feel what's going
what he wants
on
to
there.
Do, and he pulls his shirt a bit up to see
what's going to happen. It's quite well acted, by the way. But
horrible
scene.
That's horrible.
So he threatens to rape her. Then when she wakes up, then Peter enters. The man and Peter fight, and Peter gets killed.
But you already knew it from what Adam said. What Noah
said.
You
knew
yeah.
this yeah, was the moment he was going to die. But still, how he died was quite horrific with the knife slowly being pushed into his throat.
Yeah. You just think, come on, man, give a bit more power.
It is done. Elizabeth consequently smashes the man's head to pulp with a fire extinguisher.
Yeah, she goes Pulp Fiction on him. Yeah, she goes nuts. Yeah. That was nice, actually. I like that. That was justice.
It was quite a brutal scene.
Brutal justice, yeah.
So afterwards, we see that Elizabeth gets found by young Noah, which was also already foreshadowed, of course.
Yeah.
Noah told, I will take care of her after you
You're
die.
Dead. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, then in 2053, we first see Charlotte with Adam. He asks her if she made a decision to untie the knot once and for all. We later find out what that means. Later we see Elizabeth, Charlotte, Francisca and Adams that seem to be entering the blob, but I'm not completely sure. So that was episode 5. Anything? Well, you said that you started to get frustrated at this episode, right?
Yeah, I'm not sure if it was this. No, so I started at 3, then 4 somehow recovered it a bit for me. Only a bit of disappointment, but okay, this is then the origin and just more like what's going to happen then. And then season 5, actually, no, there were very good scenes in this, even if they were very brutal, but they were very good acting, like you said, the one on the caravan with Peter dying and his daughter ending up killing the horrible guy, the rapist. Yeah. That was nice. That was good done, good acted. Yeah, yeah.
And, super nice. I enjoyed watching.
Yeah, super nice scene. Yeah, nice. Yeah, yeah. Especially 2020. No, but no, it was very good acted. The other scene with Jonas dying.
Yeah.
Yeah. For me, it was interesting to see that. So they went to the power plant, and the moment they cut out a part of the gate to go and sneak in. A lot of things that are strange. It was a working nuclear power plant.
Yeah.
The gates are always electrified, like 100% sure.
Yeah, but they are not too different. That's what we talked about in season 2, that how Clausen, without any problem, can get in and get to open the barrels.
Exactly. Like, it's fine, man. Yeah, so some things, like, they should have watched Chernobyl, you know, an episode at least. Or did some, there are some things that don't make any sense. So, but it doesn't matter. They're just small details. So, that was a bit of a moment like, okay, finally, Jonas realizes, man, I don't have to trust all these people that I'm talking to.
Yeah.
And then he ends up going with her in a different time and then going to her lair. And then I still felt like he knows now, but before he was killed, he still didn't really ask questions. There was a nice scene of Martha, of Eva, saying, you have 3 lives. That was nicely put. Yeah. I liked the way they put it. And also the German language that really comes in hand. The German language...
And
I was never a big fan of, but in movies it can be really poetic. Really nice.
I really agree.
And it make a really good impression because it has a bit of harshness in it, and it's more dark also sometimes. It depends how you use it, of course.
Yeah, but to connect with what you said, what I did like about this episode is that that made me a bit like, okay, maybe there is something else happening because Jonas died, and I right away told my girlfriend like. Yeah, but she said, like, you were right at the first episode, because I already said, like, he will die. I said, yeah, but this is too early in the season. Yeah. This is too early in the season, so probably he won't die. Then.
No,
so then
I also knew it already. This is not the end frame. I knew it also.
So then I started a bit down, like, okay, maybe he doesn't die then in the end. But
to come back on what you said at the beginning, like, the frustration for me here comes about the fact that it seems like it's never ending. Like, they talk about the cycle that never loops, but I still didn't have an answer. Why is this loop never ending? Because in the end, they travel themselves back every time.
Yeah.
For me, it started here to be like, guys, why are you doing this nonstop? What's the point? Mm. All your lives are miserable. Why are you doing this?
Yeah.
And I didn't feel anymore that, also because they killed him. So I was like, okay, there's no light, there's no darkness. What is going on?
Mm. No. True. Yeah, okay, well... Probably we will see if we get some more answers in the rest of the episodes. But then if these questions still hang with you at the end, we will get into it a bit more. Yeah. A nice little detail that I found it quite clever is that you see the St. John's hangar that I think Helena has. When Katarina and Helena fight, that stays left behind on the beach. And I think that's...
Yeah. There's a Martha finds later, of course. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. In episode 2, Martha and Jonas find it. So that's a bit funny.
The epic other Jonas that kisses her.
Exactly. I like that kind of stuff when things connect into each other.
Yeah, that was nice. Yeah.
Let us know in the comments what you thought of this season and the series as a whole. And if you liked this video, share your appreciation with us by hitting the like button and please subscribing to the channel.